Paul, do you sense that Joe Cox's death will act as a game changer on the British referendum, the yes or no to Brexit question?
Well, the murder of Joe Cox has already frozen the Brexit campaign for 2 days, the two crucial days of the weekend before the vote. It's already had the effect of dampening down the rhetoric which was flying around on both sides. My sense is that Brexit is still winning, because Brexit is based on a rational and perfectly logical series of arguments that are not to do with the far right or racism, but to do with regaining economic sovereignty. I think the assassination of Joe Cox will have an effect because it took 2 days away from the campaign and it reduced the volume, it reduced the heat that was on both sides. But ultimately, many people, I would say at least into the high 40%, are utterly convinced they want to leave Europe, and they want to leave European Union because of migration.
What worries you the most after the current events? The spirit of hate and division within the British society, or Brexit per se?
I think there is no widespread spirit of hate. There is some aggressive language, but in general, The ultra-right Conservative Party, UKIP, has been using anti-migrant rhetoric. But, you know, hate speech is illegal in Britain, so they have not been using overt racist language in the way that, say, Chrissy Avgi would in Greece. So I don't believe there is a spirit of hate. There is just a heightened tension. So what does worry me the most is that we have Brexit. I am against Brexit. Not enthusiastically. I can see the arguments on both sides. But my concern is that what we are doing is handing to a bunch of people on the right of the Conservatives both the duty to renegotiate our relationship with Europe and resetting the Constitution.
Regardless of the outcome next Thursday, do you sense that Britain will be the same country after this referendum?
It's hard to say, because this referendum has energized a lot of people who are not normally involved in politics. People have felt suddenly the permission to speak in a way about migrants that they didn't speak before. That's what worries me. But their concerns about migration are legitimate, in the sense that even the government accepts that the effect on wages and the effect on housing and the effect on health and education is negative for the poorest people in Britain.